I'm going to look at running a small solar pump, 5-watt solar pump, using a supercapacitor and a solar panel. These are the lines coming in from the solar panel. It's a 50-watt solar panel, which would put way too much energy into the supercapacitor if it was just connected straight directly to it. This supercapacitor, once it gets a little bit over 15 volts, it goes over voltage and will die. It's got a few little resistors on this module here that if you only had a 5-watt solar panel, it would not go over voltage. But because I've got a larger solar panel, I need this module here to limit the voltage. This is a LM2596 step-down converter, and it's essentially limiting the voltage coming into the supercapacitor. So even if I disconnect the pump, that voltage doesn't actually increase. The little light came on and it's not letting any more voltage through to the supercapacitor. When I disconnect that solar panel, pretending that, for example, it's a cloudy day, the supercapacitor will go under voltage because the pump is consuming more energy than the solar panel is providing. I don't want it to go below 11 volts, which is why I've connected this module. So this is an under voltage protection module. It's the XHM609. So I've got the supercapacitor coming to the in, and then there's a relay that disconnects the solar pump when I've got it set to 11 volts. So when the voltage comes down to 11 volts, it will disconnect the pump. And the reason why I need to do that is because I want a 2 meter head out of my pump, and once the voltage gets below 11 volts, even though the pump's still working, it doesn't achieve that 2 meter head, and you just waste energy. So when it switches off, the solar panel is able to recharge the supercapacitor. So it's a bit of a balancing act between the energy consumed by my pump and the energy provided by the solar panel. At the moment, it's switched off the pump, and the solar panel, even though it's cloudy, is providing a reasonable amount of energy to increase the voltage in my supercapacitor. Now, I like the idea of using a supercapacitor because you can charge and discharge them as many times as you like without wearing the thing out. The life is phenomenal, even if it's being discharged and charged. So it really suits this application. This will come on at just over 12 volts and start the pump again. That's letting the solar panel charge the supercapacitor, and it'll keep doing that until it gets to around, I think it's 12.6 volts. At the moment, the sun's behind the clouds a bit, so it's not, the solar panel isn't really providing any more energy than the pump is consuming because the sun's behind the clouds. When the sun comes out from behind the clouds, it will produce more energy than what this consumes. So let's pretend that's happening and see what happens. I'll just disconnect that pump. This is still on, obviously. And the voltage will now increase. And we'll see what happens to this module. From memory, I've got it set to about 12.6 volts. And the red light comes on, and it's not increasing the voltage into the supercapacitor beyond that. Normally I'd have it set to about 15 volts for this supercapacitor, but I've just set it at 12.6 for demonstration purposes today. Noting that essentially the pump is consuming a similar amount to the solar panel because it's behind the clouds. Normally when the sun's out, the pump will be running the whole time. That's because I've got a solar panel of sufficient capacity to run this pump even when it's behind the clouds, the sun's behind the clouds. So this is a useful setup for the application that I'm trying to use this pump for, with a solar panel and a super capacitor. Thanks for watching.